This is one way to heal yourself. Tak payah nak telan vitamin, ubat dan sebagainya.
Adalah satu elemen protein yang orang-orang tempatan itu makan.
Bukan saja berkait dengan apa yang kita makan.
Badan kita ni terlampau banyak positif ion. Drive traffic jam, pergi kat tempat-tempat yang sangat sibuk. What's up everybody, welcome to a combination show of The Sky Show dengan Lesung Batu Medic Show. Hari ni kita buat recording di luar. The outside, bukan dekat Sky Clinic, bukan dekat studio. Bersama saya Dr. Shashi and kami di satu location yang I think ramai orang kenal. Backdrop kami is Gunung Kinabalu. We are at Ranau. Sempena kita buat our Sky Clinic punya wellness tour, kita ambil kesempatan untuk healing sekejap. So our topic today is healing with nature. So how you feeling? Macam mana you rasa?
Sedap. Best.
So cuaca kat sini lebih kurang 20 darjah Celsius.
25 I think.
Ketinggian sekarang ni lebih kurang 1200 kaki
dari paras laut.
Paras laut. And cuaca sangat bagus. Semalam hujan tapi pagi-pagi ni nampaknya sangat-sangat dingin dan sedap. Cahaya matahari tengah keluar and we are only 7:30.
7:30 now.
7:30 pagi sekarang ni. Masa kita buat recording.
So tiada bangunan-bangunan yang tinggi, tak ada apa-apa bunyi kenderaan, tak ada pencemaran, tiada what do you call this 5G towers yang tengah diserang.
Betul, betul.
Otak you. So, there's nothing, there's no signal sini pun kurang, not so good. Fantastic, tak apa. We came here to just chill out and be in nature kan. So kalau you guys travel tak ada phone dan sebagainya, tak apa, just buang je.
Betul, betul. So healing ni, apa kepentingan untuk kita buat sedikit detox keluar daripada hustle and bustle kota, keluar ke kawasan-kawasan yang bukan nak katakan remote tapi infrastruktur bagi saya sangat sangat elok.
Cukup untuk for daily. Look at that, banyak ni orang yang bercucuk tanam, duduk sana semua. People living here. Memang enough for people to live. Cukup.
And have a good holiday kan? Okay, so healing.
Healing.
Why is healing important?
Sebab I think most of the issues, problems pertaining to life kan, sekarang kita punya masalah kesihatan ni bukan saja berkait dengan apa yang kita makan tapi persekitaran kita juga, where we are, our surrounding kan. And what is our surrounding? Red race dekat KL, dekat mana-mana bandar. Your this one is survival, constantly on survival instinct. You kena chase something, finish something by deadline, do something, deliver something, patient, people queuing up, whatever, everything, bank or whatever. So it is like a rat race. But we only look at what we eat, exercise dan sebagainya, but we are disconnected from the nature, kan? And that's why I always say, kalau orang nak buat betul-betul ini, betul-betul kalau you come to somewhere which is like a bit more green, be in the surrounding of negative ions. This huge area ni is like a negative ion hub, kan? So away from the positive ion hub, the buildings dan sebagainya, you get away from those kind of environment, datang ke sini or anywhere which is
dekat dengan you lah.
Dekat dengan you lah. Tak payah nak pergi jauh-jauh, tak payah nak pergi Eropah ke, tak payah nak pergi anywhere yang bombastic sebab you tengok dekat Instagram and your influence. Our country has a lot of amazing destinations. You tak nak pergi ke mountain, you pergi ke laut. Anywhere where you can ground yourself. This is one way to heal yourself. People don't understand, tak payah nak telan vitamin, ubat dan sebagainya, just to this one. But periodically, I would say, every 3 to 4 months once, you just pergi around the area where you are.
Betul. So, balik kepada cerita negatif ion tu. Negatif ion ni, ialah apa yang charge yang biasa keluar daripada bumi. Okay? Badan kita ni terlampau banyak positif ion. Tambahlah dengan kita pakai baju-baju plastik, polyester. Lepas tu environment kita yang kita tak grounded, kita tak sentuh dengan tanah, dengan nature dan sebagainya. So banyak sangat penumpuan positive charge ion dalam body. So bila kita balik kepada environment macam ni, yang memang kita nampak landscape dia betul-betul cantik, pemandangan dia. So all of this tumbuh-tumbuhan pun, rainforest yang berjuta-juta tahun ni semua, dia akan bekalkan a lot of negative charge to neutralize our body.
Yes.
Secara kita tak sedar. Sama ada quality the air udara pun is like macam kita dengar macam penghawa dingin semua yang negative ion cluster semua kat sini free of charge.
Penghawa dingin semula jadi.
Free of charge this kind of udara. And kita automatically feel macam mana badan kita 7:30 pagi pun dah rasa macam dah charge up.
Yeah.
Because of the nice and the good air quality, solid sunrise yang kita dapat, all of this combination dengan nature ni.
Tak ada aircon dalam bilik, tak ada apa-apa, buka tingkap, tidur, aircon natural.
Betul, betul. And balik kepada isu macam cuti. Perlukah orang-orang yang memang sibuk-sibuk ni kadang they have to steal sometimes, curi masa sikit untuk keluar. So, jangan fikirkan macam, kadang-kadang kita pun fikir, kalau kita buat wellness workshop, kita keluar, oh sehari, dua hari, tiga hari, mungkin kita tak ada kat klinik. It's a drop of revenue dan sebagainya kan. Banyak orang bisnes akan fikir macam tu. Tapi sometimes, we need to check out. Why do you think check out too important?
Okay, this one is very important. I will always tell Dr. Roland, I just go somewhere every 3 months ke 4 months sekali. Kadang-kadang I think during the pandemic time was the worst for most people sebab tak boleh keluar mana-mana. And I remember my way of thinking, cara saya punya stress handling dan sebagainya macam pile up. And you are chasing something. Normally I'll just try to like ground back again every 3 months, 4 months, maximum pun 6 bulan I'll go somewhere he knows. So just when I come back tu, bahasa saya balik tu, the reset to macam dia macam anak panah lah, the fire, the bow is now more
calibrated,
more like, you know, like more aimed, because your mind now went free of all the things that you want to think about, like, oh, this one, that one lah, patient ni lah, patient tu lah, marketing lah, this, whatever, everything that you think about, anything, people in business ke, even if you're working with someone, it's harder to go out if you're working with people, that's one thing, sebab you nak ambil cuti panjang susah, but a good 3-4 days, good enough. Just to go, reset yourself and come back. And then masa you balik kan, you jangan merungut. Always have that element of bersyukur. Because without that, a lot of people don't have jobs. You have that. So you'll have this bersyukur mentality in you. And you come back, okay, I'm going to do this hustle. Do back again. And then go back again for a short holiday and come back. Holidays are also meant to be short and sweet. Bukan panjang-panjang, then you'll become like totally like a hippie person, susah sikit. That's different. You got a lot of responsibility. So, you want to have this short, sweet, 3-4 days, 1 week maybe, go somewhere, reset your mind, come back, be sharper. That's the reason for short vacations.
True. I think lagi satu benda is the element of our system saraf. So, yes. Biasanya kita ni drive dalam sympathetic drive. Drive traffic jam, pergi kat tempat-tempat yang sangat sibuk. Check in, check out. Hotel nak 5 bintang and everything lah. Sometimes the less expensive experience, the places yang tak hip and happening, orang yang kata macam underground ni area, or cost effective, and dia bagi you kesenangan tu. So the sympathetic drive tu, you akan rasa macam lagi chill and lagi rehat, because you akan jadi high strung. Yeah. So when you go to areas macam tu kan, so you rasa macam that holiday accessibility tu jadi senang, cost effective. And another one thing, you are macam thankful kepada nature tu. You tengok environment kat belakang ni, just look at it. It's like breathtaking. I think it's been how many years since you came to Ranau?
I think like around like 10 years maybe?
10 years lah.
12 years, I think like around like, sorry, 8 years lah. 8 years.
I datang sini masa I medical student, 2006. This is like what? 18 tahun selepas tu. So banyak perbezaan semasa perjalanan kami, walaupun kat sini hujan. I think later kita akan pergi jalan-jalan sikit. And apa lagi you nak comment? Anything you want
to say? For me, yes, because I used to pernah kerja di negeri Sabah. And saya kembali sini 2012 sampai 2014. So that was the last 10 years. And biasa kalau saya nak distress daripada kerja kat hospital kan, saya akan pergi either ke pantai dekat, pergi ke pulau-pulau mana yang dekat dengan KK Harbour tu. Lepas tu kalau my favorite activity is to hiking ke dan sebagainya. And there are a lot of trails dekat this area yang you tak payah nak hike sampai Gunung Kinabalu, tapi ada hike-hike yang kecil lain yang boleh sampai mana-mana waterfall dan sebagainya. I'll just come hike around, stay 1-2 days dekat homestay and then go back. Right, on the way, the drive here is amazing, cold, buka tingkap, drive down, tak payah aircon. And that one distresses me a lot when I was working in the hospitals. 2 hari pun cukup.
True. another like satu benda kan yang saya fikirkan sangat penting juga bila buat like small trips kan, is to plan your vacation a bit. That means you kena buat sedikit read up of the environment, plan. Because kadang-kadang location-location ni macam World Heritage Site UNESCO macam ni, dia memang terjaga, and then environment dia pun is not the same. Bukan sama macam Kuala Lumpur. Yeah, because tiba-tiba boleh hujan, tiba-tiba boleh cerah, tiba-tiba boleh panas. Macam tadi pukul 6 pagi dah mula terang. Kita dah boleh nampak
the peak,
tapi
sikit.
Sekarang ni dah mendung sikit.
And so now it's clearing up.
Dia akan clear up mungkin. Kita harap masa kita pergi kat park semua, it will clear up.
Yeah, clear up. So, when we come to this area, you kena faham, makanan kat sini pun lain.
Betul.
Few different things here. Huh? So, few yang endemic. You kena tahu, Borneo Island ni jauh daripada mainland Asia. Asian mainland.
Correct.
So, it's a separate part by itself. And it's more closer to the oceans on this side. Kan? So, dia jauh sikit. So, of course, the food here pun, kalau orang tahu dekat Sabah, dia kata pasal seafood. The seafood is amazing. Ikan-ikan, I think terlalu jumpa ikan-ikan yang pelik-pelik
dekat pasar.
Yeah, and biasanya saya, masa saya when I was staying here, saya beli ikan-ikan ni semua. I tak tahu nama dia pun apa. I steam ke, I just goreng ke, makan ke. And it tastes really good. It's different. And the prawns, biasanya I bukan orang yang suka sangat dengan prawn ni, tapi prawns kat sini memang sedap. It's very sweet. It's very fresh. So what I'll do, I'll go to the morning market and I add more seafood than I normally would dekat KL. Saya makan lebih banyak lagi seafood kat sini. And buah-buah kat sini pun, you akan tengok, buah-buah kat sini you takkan dapat kat mana-mana. Of course you can get your durian,
cemikai semua,
the normal fruit, the local fruit that you can get kat Malaysia pun, dekat Semenanjung pun, your, what you call this, your durian, your rambutan, all these things you can get. But dia ada juga buah-buah yang nak katakan endemic dekat this place ni, dekat island ni.
Endemic.
Like buah tarap, orang panggil buah tarap. And then like, what do you call this, ada lagi banyak-banyak buah yang pelik-pelik lah, especially yang quite famous dekat this Ranau area. I can't remember the names very well, tapi these are the few fruits that you get here. And different. And buah-buah ni I panggil bukan cash crop. You know why? Because not many people know about this. And buah-buah ni is naturally grown. Most of it is from the ladang-ladang orang, and bukan untuk mass sales and all those. So if you get it seasonal. So you get seasonal items here. In terms of daging and all those kind of things, I think the people here are more reliant on makanan-makanan hasil laut lebih daripada daging-daging and all those. So the food here is also very different. Of course, with all this tanah kat sini, the, what do you call this, agriculture sini pun
dah mula flourish dah.
Flourish.
I think the last time saya datang tak ada nampak macam tu banyak, tapi sekarang ni nampak macam banyak lokasi tu dah mula diteres untuk tanaman,
untuk
mungkin sayur-sayuran and everything. And also another one more thing mungkin nak tambah sikit. One element that I tengok is people dekat Borneo, bila I pergi to Sarawak, I saw a lot of them, the siput is satu element pemakanan.
Siput.
Siput. Here, di sini pun sama.
Yes.
Sama-sama. So memang ada banyak jenis
siput.
Siput harga sangat murah and high source of protein.
Yes.
Tapi bila kita cerita dalam food pyramid ke, tak ada food pyramid ke, pecah empat ke, belah empat ke, all of this thing, because semua elemen-elemen, this idea or this theory, pyramid and suku-suku separuh semua, semua datang daripada negara barat.
Yes.
They forgot, mereka lupa that this pun adalah satu elemen protein yang orang-orang,
yes,
tempatan itu makan. That's what, satu benda yang when we travel pun,
kita pun
something
makan.
kita pun makan, satu. Lagi satu is, kita pun belajar or refresh our viewpoint.
Yeah.
Because kita jarang sekarang dapat, like, boleh dapat lah kerang and all the lala semua.
Biasa orang dekat makan like siput belitung dan sebagainya. So here it's a bit more different. Siput lebih besar sikit. And orang kat Semenanjung mungkin kenal kerang je. Sini lebih daripada tu. Lala dia pun, itu Dr. Roland nampak terkejut.
Besar-besar.
So, yeah, this is one of their main protein and good fat source. And you kena tahu, most of this bottom dollars dia panggil ni kan, tinggi dengan zat-zat zinc,
iodine,
selenium and all those. So, this is a different source.
And jangan terpengaruh orang kata kolesterol daripada seafood ni bahaya. Tak ada. Actually, these are good form of kolesterol.
Makan minyak ikan tu apa?
Betul. And I think the diversity kan, masa kita buat all our workshops, we learn back, kita belajar balik. Kami sebagai physician pun kadang-kadang kita akan ada konsultasi secara online daripada orang-orang di Malaysia daripada pelbagai pelosok of the country. And kita kena understand. Even daripada sini pun kita nampak all the quality of the video call semua bagus. tak ada pun masalah. Okay. Signal semua masih okey. Tapi cuma tak adalah banyak pacak-pacak tower kat sini. But it is very very efficient for us untuk buat panggilan ke Kuala Lumpur to offer me. Tak ada masalah basic. Langsung. Hmm. So Dr. Shashi, basically I think you travel more than I do lah. Hmm. Single sikit boleh travel lah. So strategy, what is your planning? Biasanya kalau you pergi untuk cuti ni mungkin dalam setahun tu 3-4 kali tu. What's your plan like?
Okay.
Do you over rancang, okay, semua kena on point ataupun macam mana?
So when I travel, sometimes I travel alone, sometimes I travel with friends. When I travel with friends, it's a bit more easier. Senang kan? Biar dia orang planning. And then sometimes what I will do is, sometimes what I will do, I will go and research. I takkan just buang lah that. Some places I really want to go, I nak explore sikit, I akan bagi tahu dia orang, let's go here, let's go there and do. Of course the booking part and all those, I'll be like, ah, you buat. This time also, booking untuk flight dia buat, booking untuk hotel saya yang buat. So pecah-pecahkan lah that. So we'll take different route. Some people, kalau nak planning, dia akan rasa macam, you know, like so stressed out. Aku nak pergi cuti untuk hilangkan stress, tapi cuti ni pula buatkan aku stress. And so, tapi sebenarnya what you need to do is, if you're going alone, months ahead you just plan what you want to do, where you want to go, what is your date. First thing, betul lah, you kena dapatkan flight ticket dulu. So dapatkan flight ticket, you already like, alamak, aku kena buat the next phase.
Jangan book last minute juga.
Jangan book last minute, jangan malas minute, because it's more expensive of course, one thing. And then mungkin you tak dapat penginapan ke apa-apa ke, then rugi you dapat flight ticket tu, so have to change. So give yourself like at least like 1-2 months before you plan out your holiday and stays. Itu if you're going alone. If you're going with friends, agihkan. You do this, you do that, and you know those kind of things lah. Pecahkan sama anda, you guys. And also of course, please research where you're going. Kadang-kadang yang ikut je, kawan nak pergi sini, aku ikut. Tapi you have to know that if you are okay with this place, apa yang ada kat sana, if you want to go to just distress, yes, you can follow them, tapi read up, get to know apa yang ada kat tempat tu, so that you at least know. And kalau ada apa benda macam hujan ke or anything that can kacau, guys, you cannot do anything, ini nature. You have to aku kepada all these things and it will happen. Memang pernah berlaku banyak kali masa saya nak keluar, wah, nak enjoy this view, tiba-tiba hujan. So these things will happen.
Exactly, but mungkin saya sedikit beza dengan Shashi. I jenis yang kaki research sedikit sebelum pergi to the location. I just want to read up dulu a bit. Walaupun dah buat booking and everything, I would like to read up supaya kalau ada location tu, ada lagi banyak information, kita dah ada some form of entry point tadi towards the location. Because it's a new environment, we don't know the culture. Kita tak tahu culture dia, peradaban dia macam mana, apa nak anticipate. Memang kadang-kadang kita anticipate macam semalam, kita anticipate datang hujan je. Tapi hari ni, now we can see the peak. That's just a very lucky to see the peak at the moment. So early in the morning, memang cantik.
Kinabalu eh?
Dia guna Kinabalu sekarang ni. 4095 meters above sea level.
Above sea level.
Yeah, so.
So Dr. Rin, kalau dah keluar daripada tempat ni, biasanya kita yang biasa buat some workout dekat KL, masa kita working ni, kerja ni. So masa keluar cuti macam mana pula? How's your son? I saw you the other day, bangun pagi-pagi dah terus pergi jogging. Aku macam, dia ni cuti.
Pergi jogging, pergi pasar.
Di pasar lagi.
Okay. So, bila travel ni kadang-kadang tengok pada location. Bila kita daripada flight, daripada KL pergi KLIA dah 2 jam, 3 jam. Naik flight lagi 2 jam. And then, the humidity of the flight and everything kan. Biasanya buat you rasa badan you sangat kering. I think. So, hydration satu benda yang penting. And then, sometimes I just want to activate my body sebab kita duduk je. Duduk. Kadang-kadang travel dalam bas duduk. Travel dalam bas persiaran duduk. And everything. So, I biasanya akan reki lah. Maksudnya, keluar in the morning. Kalau tak hujan and everything, have a good run. Just to sweat, just to break the energy out. Have a shower. Start the day. Because kadang-kadang ada hotel yang mungkin ada kelengkapan gym
dan sebagainya.
But just to break the sweat, I just like to do that. Because there's less traffic and everything. Just to run around and see the environment of the area. And then you boleh kawal jugalah. 10,000 kaki tu dah buat, dah settle lah. Settle lah.
That is something that normally kalau macam saya, if I go somewhere yang baru, maybe because Sabah is somewhere I've been before, I don't consider myself tourist here. I just datang sini je. And the thing is, kalau if I'm going travelling somewhere biasanya, I will biasanya jalan. This time, kereta sewa dan sebagainya. Tapi, if I'm going somewhere, like when I went recently, jalan je. Bangkok ke Kochiga, just walk, walk, just jalan-jalan, more than 10,000 settle. One day I mungkin dah tengah hari I kena balik tukar baju sebab dah perlu.
And plus dalam situation macam holiday kita akan mulut kita akan terlampau teringin untuk makan a lot of things.
Yes.
So kita nak experiment on new food. Tak, yang yeah. Kita tak boleh fikir macam over dieting semua kan. So
because you are now
kita
enjoying.
compensate that calories by walking and moving around. So that is plus minus lah. You win some, you burn some lah.
So and you nak balance this out. So don't stress out too much about your food and all this. I pun cakap bagi tahu Dr. Roland semalam, ini dah lepas I punya cara makanan ni. I was like already like few days dah out of my comfort zone of food. Ada makan roti dan sebagainya, which is not normally what I will eat normally. But when you are here, you're traveling, de-stress. Just have it on the go. Bukan jadi macam your daily routine. Nothing, yeah.
So you just want to mind this element of reward centric. So reward centric ni akan be like, okay, you duduk dalam satu hotel yang cantik, chalet yang cantik, makan tu you macam, kalau you extra calorie pun, just balik tu cuba burn out.
Kan, you're going to go back and then you're going to do all this. You're going to reset yourself better. Even your workout pun akan jadi lebih baik lagi.
Jangan datang kat sini nak buat idea intermittent fasting semua. Don't kill yourself.
Jangan torture diri sendiri.
Because kadang-kadang ada buffet kat hotel dan sebagainya. So don't overkill, tapi be moderate lah.
Tapi I dah AF dah. Semalam I makan.
Oh, bagus. Dia tidur terus.
Tidur terus. I tak makan, makan malam. Makan tengah hari terus. Tidur, bangun pagi ni. Lepas ni baru nak makan.
Okay. So one element yang I feel is work-life balance. Work-life balance ni sometimes is kita kena balance of our chase than our rest. I call it the work tu jadi satu play. Kita akan suka kerja tu bila kita
you rasa bukan work, it's like your favorite thing to do.
Betul
kan?
Betul. And then bila kita we took this opportunity macam kita tengah buat all our workshops and road trips ke seluruh Malaysia ni is untuk bawa that message juga. Selain kita memang doktor, kita memang ambil kesempatan satu hari kita datang, kita buat workshop, kita buat training, kita interact with the local people, ramai yang datang for the events, and then kita juga singgah, ambil juga some time to check out, to go
the
out
local places, the local
enjoy the environment.
And biasanya sekarang kita lebih cakap pasal work life balance ni lebih daripada zaman-zaman dulu, sebab saya rasa dekat di mana-mana lah, bukan KL je lah, anywhere, I think the whole world, work ni dah tak ada ending. Sebab dulu saya biasa bandingkan hidup kita sekarang dengan hidup masa zaman mak ayah kita ke atau datuk nenek kita kan, sebab tak ada orang yang akan message you lepas you balik kerja. Pukul 5 dah habis, settle balik, itu je. Dekat sekarang, I mean zaman sekarang, KL ni, anywhere, daripada cikgu ke doktor ke siapa-siapa, you akan message at any time, at any point, just to ask what is going on or anything like that. The work macam tak habis. Boss you mungkin akan chase you untuk buat kerja or something like that. Laptop you, ramai yang kerja sampai late night. Dah balik dari office, laptop dekat rumah. Oh, there's no balance much. So when you go for this kind of places, holidays and all those, I'll tell people, jangan bawa your work stuff to this place, if you can. Sebab ini dah cuti. You want to de-stress and get away from this kind of things, and you want to totally immerse dekat this local environment. So that's one very very important thing. Kalau boleh, beritahu boss you, this 3-4 days bagi I
time. Jangan hantar email.
Jangan hantar email. Bagi I for few days untuk bagi I reset balik, I'll come back stronger. Something like that. The way you convince and tell people what you want to do. Very important.
Right. So to wrap up, thank you for all the support yang kita dapat daripada semua wellness workshop yang kita buat. We still got a couple of wellness workshop di seluruh Malaysia kita nak pergi. Kita akan pergi ke Pantai Timur lepas ni. Lepas tu kita akan pergi ke utara balik, Penang, Ipoh. Dan kita akan buat lagi satu wellness workshop yang besar dekat Kuala Lumpur coming soon. So all the links, siapa-siapa yang nak join our wellness workshop, is below. Nanti you boleh klik, you boleh scan, dan kita akan maklumkan kepada you guys wellness workshop yang mana paling terdekat untuk you datang. Banyak topik yang kita discuss dari segi pemakanan, dari segi de-stressing, dari segi antioksidan. Banyak benda-benda kita tentang cover. And this one again, before we wrap up, nice view.
View is amazing. Orang yang akan datang ke wellness KL workshop ni, it's going to be a bit more of a different level, a bit more of like hacking, biohacking, dia kata. So basically bukan pasal you sakit tu dan sakit ni dan sebagainya, macam mana nak betulkan? It's because you want to go from one level to a higher grade. Tak sakit lagi. This is going towards beyond getting easily sakit dan sebagainya. It's a different level.
Kita akan bawakan topik-topik yang lagi mungkin yang never been discussed pun.
Yeah.
Dekat antara doktor kita akan bawakan dari segi DNA testing, gut microbiome. So many new topics we have in our sleeve. We will share because this is what public kena tahu. This is what people kena enjoy the nature, enjoy themselves, enjoy their life. Okay, so thank you so much untuk tonton collaboration show antara
Sky
Show dengan Lesung Batu. Siapa yang
any queries, DMs,
jangan lupa like, subscribe, follow our page, and we see you in the next episode. Take care.
See you guys.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. And enjoy the whole nice scenery of Ranau.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.